Well, hello again. So I think this is like week three, week four, week three, and we've been working on the van. What have we done this week? Well, it probably doesn't look much to you from the video. But this week, I had to go back to Wickes and just buy some extra cladding to finish it all off. I had to buy some extra insulation board. I still can't believe that since doing this, and compared to what I used to have, I've got four large extra sheets of 25 mil Sellotex and s five rolls of 12 mil closed cell foam added to the insulation on the van. So, like I said in last week's, there's a lot more insulation being added to the van. Some of the things I've done this week, the fridge wasn't working, a few electrical faults. So I took the fridge out, cleaned it all up. I basically opened it one day and I was like, oh, that's a bit smelly. The fridge hadn't been kicking in. So I think one of the things that you learn over time and get better at is understanding electrics a lot more. So I upgraded the cable from what it was originally fitted when I first built the van to what it is now, and since then run that straight into the fuse box, no issues whatsoever. Fridge is running perfect, so that's one fault. Then I had some other faults. I spoke to a friend online, FaceTime, talked through a few things, so I've managed to strip out the lights in the van, apart from these two, which are still not working. And so I've managed to swap out these lights and these lights, and they're all working fine. Don't understand beyond me. So another friend has kindly allowed me to go and visit them, and I'm looking very much looking forward to that. And at the same time, they're going to help me fit my aux beam light bar in. So we're basically at the stage now where I've done all the insulation and so on. Kind of like the box seat, which wasn't there last week, is done. I've done a few more things, and I'll flip the camera around in a minute. And then all that's left to do is, like, Sunday I've got to go away for a whole week and work. So once I'm back around the 11th of April, I'm then going to jump in the van, drive to a friend's, park up for a couple of days. Got to strip out the whole of the front parcel shelf cab area, fit the light bar, re-insulate it. And then some of the other things that I am going to do is I've taken out what was my old reversing camera, which was pretty poor. I'm then going to upgrade my reversing camera. So I've left the back end here where the wiring is for the power for the camera. And then once we do this area, we can then think about where the control panel for the aux beam is going to go, and the reversing mirror sort of thing camera. So yeah, a few more things to do. So still got some electrical issues. Again, still got my B2B issue. So I'm hoping my friend on that week of the 11th will be able to help me out with that as well. So we'll see. We'll see. So I'm going to flip the camera around and show you what we've done and all that sort of stuff. Hopefully, it's getting there slowly. Like I say, one thing I am definitely not is an electrician. I'm not an expert at fault checking things and this, that, and the other, and understanding it still. But I'm slowly getting there, slowly getting better. Considering I couldn't do my own lights or cabling before, and I've gone in and rewired a fridge and lighting by myself today, is pretty impressive. I'm not a professional van builder, but it is what it is. But it's my van, I'm happy, and I'm in a t-shirt still because it's nice and warm. So let's flip the camera around because I'm waffling crap. So we've given, I did say in the last video, we're going to use like an off-white grey. It looks blue to me, but I think that's just the color that comes out. But we've used this off-white grey on the cupboards and all that sort of stuff. They've all been cleaned up. Eventually, I'm going to buy some new, like, 12 more ply and make some better cabinet doors. But every day is a school day, and I'm learning. the baton is in, which will become like a fixing point for the new shelf once the bulkhead is in, which is going to be here. And like I said, the bulkhead will come out to where my hand is. Just a mini bulkhead, but that'll have 25mm insulation in. And then from here, I can build off across to the fixing point on the piece of wood that's been feeding there. All the cladding's in. Just needs to be stained still. What else? This seat in area has been done. So this is not as long, but wider. So it's kind of like a dog bed, and which is what I wanted. And all it is, it's just a box seat with a lid that sinks down into it. It's still got a bit of a bend in it, so it's comfy. Two little holes for lifting out. And inside, that's been fully insulated. There's a little step over here because down, you can't see it, but one of my LPG heater vents comes in. So this little step here, yeah, so that just fits in there. So that's all either got 25mm or 50mm Sellotex all in that seating area as well. I've made these like little silver foil back things. These are for the windows, and the whole idea of this. So the box seat lid, you have to excuse me, I've got a bad arm for some reason, I don't know. So as soon as I grab onto something, my whole arm just goes sore and weak. So I've got this, which is the lid, two little holes that just slots back in onto the seat. And then on there, cushions and all that sort of stuff. I am going to get some new foam made up to sit on there. But what I have been making, all about insulation, just whether it works or not, a bit of double backed silver foil. I've then carpet lined these. They're cut to size, so basically the curtains are great as blackout curtains, but they're dog shit for insulation. So these just wrap around the back of the curtains, around, like so. And then by drawing the original curtains, that just keeps it against the glass. So, and I have noticed that it does keep a bit more warmth in by just doing that. And the same coloured fabric as around the door. So the one thing I did want is a bigger area to sit on, but also kind of like a mini dog bed for Archie, because although he's quite a big dog, I'm hoping that sometimes in winter, because does rise, especially in the van, that he can jump on here when it's a bit colder and obviously sleep where the heat's a bit more raised. Anyway, that's the plan. One of the things I did want back, which from when I originally extended, was I had a little narrow walkway in and out of the van, which was a pain in the ass for me. I always like sitting on the doorstep of the van looking outside, so I've got that back. What else have we done? Apart from painting, probably doesn't seem like a lot to be honest, but we have been working all week. It's been mainly replumbing the electrics, the water into the tank, redoing some of the electrics, the toilet. There's no back underneath the bed where it was originally intended to be, but I moved over here, which doesn't work, but that's no back over there. So that's back in. Nested tables, so I've got bigger working area. I showed you that last week. I have carpet lined all around the edge of the bed, which just needs a clean up from working. Uh, My control panel is in, so I don't have the iPad mounted up there anymore, but I have the inverter for the TV, as I showed you last week. That's all in. Yeah, we're pretty much getting there, so I'm hoping that now. So there you go. I've shown you around what I've done in the van. It probably doesn't seem like a lot, but over the course of this week, we have actually done quite a bit. So like I said, there's 4 sheets of 25mm Sellotex. Where the hell has all that gone? No idea. The 6 rolls, 5 rolls of like closed cell foam, that's all in here as well. Where's all that gone? No idea. Well, I do, but it's getting there as far as I'm concerned. It feels warmer, it feels cozier. I'm parked up at my mother's still, so although the temperature is due to drop tonight to around -3 around here, like it did last night, so I've been out and got some more LPG. I'm gonna put the cover on the outside of the van, the window, like I normally do in winter, because I haven't got the bulkhead in. I'm just gonna cover that up, and I'm gonna sleep in here tonight, so and just see how it feels. And then, like I said, work on, gonna get a bus into London, and then I'm at work for a week in London, and then I'm back around the 10th, 11th of April, and then I'll be packing the van and off to go and see another friend, and they're going to help me, like I say, do some other stuff, fit the light bar, which I've been promising Auxbeam that I'd get to do. Sorry, Auxbeam. And hopefully solve a few more electrical issues out and learn at the same time. So they're my biggest plans, and they're the thing. So next week there won't be a video, or unless I take the camera with me and do some video while I'm in London, but I'll be working. So probably won't be a video next week, but I'll be back the week after that for an update. So as always, I've got a tickly cough. As always, thanks for watching. Your support has been amazing on all these update videos and all the comments that you leave us. So thank you very much for that. And hopefully we'll see you back on the road very, very soon. Bye-bye.